Dobar dan, dragi gledalci. U našoj današnjoj emisiji imat ćete prilike da vidite promociju knjige Tesla, A Portrait with Masks, doktora Vladimira Pištala. Vladimir Pištalo je doktorirao na američkoj istoriji, napisao je 12 knjiga i mnoštvo priča. Posle veoma pozitivnih kritika usledila je i američka turneja, a nedavno je boravio u Torontu da promoviše svoju knjigu. Program je vodio Nenad Stanković. Pogledajte kako je to izgledalo.
I want to thank you, Nenad, and the Tesla magazine that keep informing people about Tesla, and not just in our country, but in Canada, in America. But there was something about the book that really meant a lot to people. And that year, after it got the NIN award, it got another award, which is really... it meant a lot to me. It was the book that was read the most in the libraries of Serbia. And why it meant a lot to me is because first, both my mother and my father were connected with libraries. My father was the director of the university library in Sarajevo, and my mother was actually working in the library when I was in her womb. And she didn't give exactly birth in the library. That would be an overstatement. Mm-hmm. But she left the library in order to go to the hospital. Back then, these were different times. She didn't even take a cab. She just went home, ate something, and caught a tram and went from that library. And I was kind of being formed among the books while she was working there. So why that award of the Serbian libraries was so important to me? Because any group of critics, which is usually five critics, I know something about that. I don't know how the textbooks are created, but I know that the literary awards could be given, and Tesla himself was rather suspicious about awards. He was criticizing, you know, even the Nobel Prize. He was saying that it is a group of people that might be prone to error. But the libraries, it is something that is really measurable. People go there and they offer their library card and it is stamped, and it is really the number of these people who check the book out decides about that award. And why am I'm telling you all of this? Usually it was happening that the books that are the most read were kind of the books, how should I put it, popular, of lower quality. And the NIN award was given to the books that were considered to be literature. And so the staff of the university library was kind of deciding to divorce these two things from each other, to give the award for the best book from the libraries to the book that is also valuable. That year, actually, these two things coincided. The book that got NIN award was not some love story, whatever, that was popular. It was actually the book about Tesla. So that award is maybe even more important than the NIN award. And then the life of the book continued. I don't know. Me and my publisher, Nenad Šapunja, we probably had 200 readings all across the region. And then when the book appeared in English, it kind of started a separate life of this book in English language. We had perhaps 10 readings, I didn't count them all, last year, two of them in Boston, two of them in New York City, two of them in Chicago, in Washington, D.C., two readings in the Library of Congress, all around New England, in my alma mater, University of New Hampshire. Charlie Simic, my friend, the famous Serbian-American poet, introduced the book. He also wrote the blurb for the book. And it was kind of a different crew. And at the end of each one of these conversations with the audience, I have an opportunity and the pleasure to actually answer the questions that people want to ask me. And that is kind of an important part to me, because different people ask you different questions. Serbian audience different than the American one. The people in the various places ask you different things. And apparently Tesla is an unusual subject. There is something about Tesla and the legend about Tesla and the myth of Tesla that exceeds just the field of science. There is some kinds of spiritual excitement that his unusual life and that his spirituality kind of evokes in people. And I just, some people feel very strongly, you know, that the Serbian Orthodox Church was thinking about canonizing Tesla. So some people think it is great, some people are very angry because they think it is really mixing apples and oranges. But what is important, it is very unusual that the church would be even think about canonizing somebody who was basically, whose favorite writer was Voltaire. And his father was a priest, and his entire life was kind of a negation of that. But there is something very spiritual and particular about this subject that that I think keeps drawing attention to Tesla. And I keep telling my friends when we talk about that, I was in Banski Dvori in Banja Luka. I don't know, maybe some of you guys know what I'm talking about, a very, very wonderful building where the government the things are happening, and it was packed. And one gentleman said, he said, you know, we lived through this terrible war, and this terrible war left the hole in our soul, and that hole was filled by Tesla. So for how many figures from the public life would anybody think about saying like something like that? That means how much Tesla meant to so many people.
Iskusite najbolje od inovacije High Park Nissan. U High Parku Nissanu vas očekuje tim profesionalaca koji će odgovarati na sva vaša pitanja u vezi novih Nissan automobila i načina plaćanja. Za više informacija u vezi novih Nissan vozila i nula kamatnih stopa, javite se Marku, Niku ili Banetu na 416-762-7537 ili dođite u High Park Nissan na adresu 3275 Dundas Street West.
Gospodine Pištolo, sada ste drugi put u Torontu, sada je povod u stvari ova knjiga koja je o Tesli, koja je prevod na engleski jezik, izašla je prošle godine u Americi. Kakvi su vam utisci sada posle, ovo je, ja mislim, drugo izdanje ove knjige, pošto je prvo izdanje za tri meseca rasprodato?
Pa veoma mi je drago da sam ponovo u Torontu i u Kanadi. Počeo je moj boravak veoma lepo zato što kada sam došao na carinu, pitala me žena zašto sam ovdje, ja sam rekao da imam čitanje, ona je rekla u kome, ja sam rekao ne znam da li ne znate slučajno o Nikoli Tesli, ona kaže slučajno, kao da se uvredila i kaže gde je to čitanje i zainteresovala se i htjela je da kupi knjigu na Amazonu. Ne dešava se čovjeku svaki put kad uđe u neku zemlju da se carinik zainteresuje za knjigu. To pokazuje, ja mislim, to da Tesla, koliko god je kult figura i koliko god je relativno nepoznat, postoji snažno interesovanje koje je, kao što bi rekli, undercurrent. Postoji neprestano interesovanje koje ne jenjava, tako da ja mislim da će se interesovanje za Teslu samo povećavati, a idealno bi bilo, ja bi to želeo od sveg srca, da se jednog dana snimi dobar film o Teslu.
Kakav je život knjige? Sada je drugo izdanje i knjiga se može poručiti preko Amazona i može se poručiti u knjižarama Indigo i Chapters u Kanadi, ali je nema na rafovima.
Ja bih mnogo više volio da je bude na rafovima, jer recimo u Barnes & Noble ona je bila u Discover Great Writers 3 mjeseca, što je jedan lep način prezentacije. Ja mislim da bi u Kanadi bilo publike za tu knjigu i ja bih jako volio da je ona više prisutna. Knjiga je nominovana za National Book Award u Americi, imala je dobre prikaze, svi prikaze u stvari su bili dobri i meni bi bilo drago da takav život knjiga nastavi i u Kanadi. Ja se nadam da se tu možda može nešto uraditi u smislu njenog prisustva u knjižarama.
Koliko knjiga može da doprinese interesovanju i artikulaciji u stvari interesa za Teslu u Severnoj Americi?
Pa ja se nadam da može, zato što je moja knjiga zaista roman. ona naseljava tesan lik iznutra i koristeći i poeziju i humor i metafore na jednim tako reći filmskim jezikom priča njegovu priču. I mislim da čovjek može da osjeti Teslu kao čovjeka i da saučestvuje sa njime mnogo više nego da ga gleda samo figuru kojom se divi. Jedan od mojih namjera kada sam pisao tu knjigu je upravo da ona na jedan neposredniji način nam učini Teslu bliskim. Ono što sam rekao da knjiga Umetnost inače otvara oči za određene fenomene. I mislim da ova knjiga otvara oči na jedan drugačiji način za Teslin život.
Dobro, kako vidite život knjige, dalje život knjige u Americi?
Pravo da vam kažem, ne znam, to ne zavisi od mene. To je kao kad mi ljudi pitali da li očekuješ da dobiješ ovu ili onu nagradu. To ljudi ne mogu da znaju. Bilo bi mi drago da izađe još jedno izdanje kod moga izdavača i bilo bi mi drago da knjiga ima i život u ostalom delu engleskog područja. Govorimo ne samo o Kanadi, nego i Americi, Australiji i New Zealandu. I konačno, zaista bih voleo da se Tesla približi gledaocima i čitaocima i kroz film. Jer kao što knjiga može da približi Teslin život i lik, film još više ima mogućnost da to učini.
Dobro, knjiga je prevedena na 13 jezika. Koje su izdanja sada, koje očekujete, koji su zadnji jezici na koje je prevedena?
Evo, bugarski prevod je završen pre 2 dana. I pitala me prevoditeljica neka stručna pitanja na koje sam odgovorio, uvek volim da sarađujem sa prevodiocima, govori se o ponovnom prevodu na ruski. Velika prevoditeljica Larisa Seveljeva bi ovoga puta to radila, jer bilo bi jako dobro da ona to uradi. Španski, potpisan je ugovor za španski prevod, ponuđen mi je ugovor za turski prevod, postoji mogućnost za grčki i za albanski, ali to je u pregovorima. Ovi drugi su potpisani ugovori.
Dobro, ovo je vaša prva knjiga na engleskom, prevedena na engleski. Možemo kažemo nešto o životu knjige u Kanadi, da li očekujete još neke prezentacije i čitanja u Kanadi?
Pa bilo je nekih ponuda, znate, ja nisam independently wealthy, ja predajem na fakultetu, tako da to treba i dogovoriti. Postoji neka mogućnost da se to uradi u Vancouveru, postojali su još neki drugi pozivi, ali vidjet ćemo. Moj prevod druge knjige, Milenijum u Beogradu, je isto u toku, tako da bi moglo da se desi da se ta knjiga pojavi na engleskom govornom području uporedo sa Teslom.
Dobro, hvala vam što ste bili u Torontu i nadam se da ćemo se vidjeti opet.
Hvala vam.
Iskusite najbolje od inovacije High Park Nissan. U High Parku Nissanu vas očekuje tim profesionalaca koji će odgovarati na sva vaša pitanja u vezi novih Nissan automobila i načina plaćanja. Za više informacija u vezi novih Nissan vozila i nula kamatnih stopa, javite se Marku, Niku ili Banetu na 416-762-7537 ili dođite u High Park Nissan na adresu 3275 Dundas Street West.
Zeus commands the thunderbolt. Suddenly, there came from heaven a sound as of a violent wind, which filled the entire house in which they were sitting. And there appeared to them tongues as of fire. These separated and came to rest on the head of each of them. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit. The Acts of the Apostles, 2:2-4. Zeus creates lightning, people don't. Colomancito murmured to himself. The assistant stood with his legs apart and furtively observed his boss. Although he was not exactly a hunchback like Igor from Edison's circus tent, the Hungarian was still somewhat stooped. When the gush of magnetic energy hits the Gorgon, Tesla shouted, the coil will create an avalanche that will raise the electrical potential of the earth. Do you see? Electricity will erupt back from the ground. See, he snarled. Our mast will fire up thunderbolts. Zeus commands the thunderbolt, Cito whimpered. The assistant realized that Tesla was ready to risk his own life using the highest voltage ever produced. Cito too was playing Russian roulette, since he, not Tesla, operated the switch that controlled the flow of electricity from power plant. When I give you the sign, pull the lever, Tesla ordered with suicidal resolve. He found a spot from which he could see through the open roof. Now, Cito jerked the lever. A swarm of electrical snakes covered the coil. A hissing sound spread throughout the room. It works, Tesla's voice thundered. Do it again. The fairy's hair got entangled on the coil once more. The laboratory turned blue and started to crackle. A dull boom reported from the mast. I'm going to go outside and look at the mast, Tesla was merciless. I want you to pull the lever and hold it till I say so. Swaying on his thick rubber-soled shoes, Manfred stepped out of the barn. Pull the lever. Cito pushed the lever and held it with his extended arm, waiting for the signal to jerk it back. A few seconds passed. The sorcerer and his apprentice were still alive. Nothing smelled burned. Like a gold coin, a whole wondrous minute fell with a clink on the stone floor. Then came the real awakening of the Furies. Tesla crossed the point of no return, and he's launched into the shoreless void of a new phenomenon. Inside, the crackling of the Gorgon's hair rose to a crescendo. Outside, a single thread of lightning wriggled off the mast. Then a second one, a third, a fourth. Thunder exploded, and Tesla flinched against his will. Dear mother, thunder exploded again. He ducked as it cracked once more. The noise from the mast sounded like a rifle, then like a cannon, and soon became even louder, until it seemed as though they were in the middle of the Battle of Austerlitz. The building was a straw in a flashing whirlwind. The Furies, the first human thunder maker whispered vengefully, the Furies. Spectral blue light appeared in the barn. A mass of live electrical hair slithered around the coils. Everything in the building spewed needles of light. A pandemonium of sounds broke free. There was a stench of sulfur. Cito clenched his jaw and broke a tooth as he tried to suppress the trembling in his body, lest he might let go. His left arm shook so much he was not able to cross himself. In the blue shimmer that completely surrounded him, he almost expected to see the spirits of his late parents. He felt sparks popping painfully from his fingers. He felt that his blood would gush out from under his nails. The electric maelstrom threatened to destroy the barn. Nikola Tesla stood outside, neatly dressed, with his laced high-top shoes and bowler hat. The sky screamed and the earth responded. A new Mephistopheles grew taller under the night sky, starched by lightning. Sparks flew around the rubber soles of his shoes. The awakened earth had a message for him. The awakened earth sparkled all around him. Lightning became thicker and brighter, clearer and bluer. Sparks as big as a fist shot into the sky. Sea snakes wriggled upward, 80, then 120 feet above the ground. The rumbling echoed for miles. With his face altering from black to silver, the Victorian Thundermaker, in his Prince Albert coat, surveyed them. He was the light, a flashing impersonal force. How long has this been going on? Cito trembled. This is forbidden. A mortal shouldn't do this. In the blink of an eye, everything went dead. Everything. Cito, did you pull the lever? Tesla launched at him. The Hungarian looked at him with his bloodshot eyes, haunched like a bull with banderillas sticking in his back. No, he gasped. Call the power plant. They mustn't do this to me. They mustn't cut me off. "What are you talking about?" a deranged voice shouted on the phone when Cito called. "You caused a short circuit. Our generator is on fire."
Iskusite najbolje od inovacije High Park Nissan. U High Parku Nissanu vas očekuje tim profesionalaca koji će odgovarati na sva vaša pitanja u vezi novih Nissan automobila I načina plaćanja. Za više informacija u vezi novih Nissan vozila I nula kamatnih stopa, javite se Marku, Niku ili Banetu na 416-762-7537 ili dođite u High Park Nissan na adresu 3275 Dundas Street West. Dragi gledalci, došli smo do kraja današnje emisije. Za sve sugestije, informacije I mogućnosti reklamiranja možete nas potražiti na našem web sajtu www.srbijantoronto.tv. Možete nas pratiti na Twitteru I lajkovati na Facebooku. Moje ime je Miljana Ristić, hvala vam na pažnji I doviđenja.
Earthquake. Many years ago in this very city, on South 5th Street, Sicilian women with cracked faces arranged oysters on wooden boards covered with seaweed. Rotten cabbage heads rolled down the street. Live fish splashed in buckets. It smelled like smoke. In a side alley, some boys played baseball under bedspreads hanging from clotheslines. They felt at home in chaos. Tonino, I'll kill you if the ball messes up the laundry, shouted mothers from the windows. Artists from Upper Manhattan used to come with their sketchbook to this exotic part of the Lower East Side to draw street scenes from Naples or Damascus. That day, on their way to Damascus, the artists felt the ground shift under their feet. The cobbled street started to shake. The glass panes on the Panetteria Italiana rattled. In the bakehouse, a chair first jumped up and then, in two or three hops, limped to the side. Pots and pans started to shake. The head of a crystal chandelier swung sharply. Mysterious waves traveled through what Henry James would call tiny, vulgar streets. "Earthquake," announced an enlightened voice from a window. "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, even birds in flight were shaken." A young woman gave a shrill cry, like glass being cut. In a maelstrom of shouts, the cursing of carriage drivers merged with the wailing of pedestrians. Carmine Rocca hastily collected his wares. A large eggplant fell into the cobbled street. The buckets tipped over. The fish flopped in the dust. All of East Manhattan was shaking. The conductor of the L stopped the train. The voices went hoarse as they shouted, "Earthquake!" The two policemen ran left and right, not knowing where to go first. "Wait a minute," said the man from Taormina. "This isn't an earthquake. An earthquake stops after the first shock, but this is getting stronger. It must be that crazy scientist." Tesla chuckled at this point in the story. "He's going to kill us all. Let's kill him before he kills us." "Go upstairs quick," the people shouted. The helmet fell over the policeman's eyes. Stumbling, he rushed up my staircase. "Actually," said Nikola Tesla softly, "that morning I fastened a small oscillator on the bearing wall of my laboratory on South 5th Street. As new oscillations combine with the existing oscillations, they amplified and traveled to the foundations of the building. As the whole of Manhattan started to shake, my room was as quiet as an eye of a hurricane. Bam, 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 the situation turned serious. Bam, 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 the policemen were banging on my door." Tesla smiled slyly. "I hit the oscillator with a hammer. I closed my eyes and sighed as everything quieted down completely. On that day, the entire Lower East Side was abuzz about the mysterious earthquake. There was a rumor that two women miscarried, that L derailed, that construction workers jumped off scaffoldings, that robbers fled from the bank, that a panicking woman threw her child out of the window, that some man who happened to look up caught it. that a bearded Russian swept the silver coins of his eyes with the back of his hand, got up from his deathbed, and took off down the stairs.